Over 1,000 medical and non-medical personnel volunteered to become part of former Vice President Lenny Robredo's telemedicine program amid rising COVID-19 infections in the country. Robredo initially sought to have around 50 volunteers, and she announced the revival of her Bayanihan e-consulta service. But she says the number of volunteers reached over 1,000 just after an hour the sign-up sheet was posted online. The Bayanihan e-consulta program, which started in 2021 under the Office of the Vice President, connects COVID-19 patients to volunteer doctors. It was closed a month before Robredo stepped down from office. Robredo has yet to announce when the telemedicine operations will resume.
The Philippines is also facing an uptick in COVID cases. The health department reported 2,828 new infections on Thursday, the highest daily tally in over 5 months or since February 13. 1,000 of the new cases are from Metro Manila. Active cases now stand at 22,207, the highest since April 15. Health experts urge Filipinos to get their booster shots following the emergence of the new BA.2.75 Omicron subvariant. It has been detected in at least 10 countries and is said to be 18 times more transmissible than the original Omicron strain.
If you look at the genetic tree of the Omicron variant, as they evolve, there is always that increased transmissibility and the ability to evade the vaccines.
Booster dose ay nag-expand, nagbo-broaden yung kanyang immune response, yung mga iba-ibang klase niyang mga antibodies, for instance, na mako-cover kasama yung mga variants. So meron silang mga pag-aaral ngayon na okay pa naman.
Filipino activists launched a campaign to highlight abuses committed by the martial law regime of the late Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. The campaign aims to counter attempts to whitewash the brutal period ahead of the 50th anniversary of the Declaration of Martial Law. Adrian Ayalin reports.
Never again to martial law!
It may be the golden anniversary of the declaration of martial law by former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. this year, but for activists, what transpired during the dictatorship were far from golden. Various groups and individuals, including survivors of martial law, launched ML50 to commemorate the 50th anniversary of military rule in the country as declared on September 21, 1972. Former political prisoners Judy Taguiwalo and Joel Lamangan led the launch of more than 2 months' worth of activities, which include film screenings, fora, and webinars. Lamangan, a film director, even said that he is ready to direct a film to counter present efforts at revising history, particularly the pro-Marcos film made in Malacanang. The movie is about the last 72 hours of the Marcoses inside Malacanang Palace before fleeing to Hawaii during the 1986 People Power Revolution.
Ako manonood ba ako? Oo, manonood ako. Titingnan ko kung gano'n ito ka**** at sasabihin ko sa mga tao kung paano na hindi totoo ang lahat ng ito. At gagawa ako ng pelikula laban dito.
Taguiwalo and Lamangan recalled their activist days during martial law, which should be remembered all the more that the son of the late dictator, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., is now the country's president.
Napaka-ironic na sa taong ito, ang nakaupo sa Malacanang ay ang ikalawang Marcos. Lungkot, panlulungo, galit, ang naramdaman ko nung nanalo sa isang eleksyon na questionable, no? Ang isang tao na may na hindi nagbayad ng buwis at walang malinaw na track record.
For relatively younger activists, there is an imperative need to remind the present generation of the past with Marcos Sr. and the present with Marcos Jr.
Maraming kabataan ang nagbuwis ng buhay dahil sa pagtatanggol ng ating karapatan. Mula noon hanggang ngayon, nandyan ang mga martir gaya ni Edgar Hobson, ni Jessica Sales.
At the end of the launch and press conference, the activists went outside after learning that policemen were gathered across the venue. Bayan Chairperson Carol Araulio approached the policemen.
I told them to leave because they have no reason to be here. We are merely commemorating the 50th year of martial law and all its lessons. What is the reason for being here? To intimidate us? If this is a signal, we are not intimidated.
Sir, pag po nandito kayo,
pressed if they were there by chance or because anti-martial law activists were in the area, the policemen kept their silence. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.